Hey guys, Cambridge here, clean, back at it with another video for you guys, and I'm back with another My Happy Marriage episodes review for you guys, as I missed last week's, or actually 2 weeks ago, as well as obviously I didn't do my review on the last episode, but the last two episodes were good. Even the episode 2 weeks ago was just a phenomenal episode. And again, this show continues to be a very underrated sleeper anime show. And thank goodness, because even though right now it seems like it looks a lot better than it does, than it looked like, because in California, it looked like we were going to get hit with a hurricane, but I guess it wasn't as bad as people were making it out to be. So, hey, listen, I'll take it. So I'm actually technically making this review while I'm technically working at home because we were told to stay at home. So, hey, that means I can get actually some videos edited and done while working at the same time, since I don't really have a lot of tasks to do today. But regardless, the episodes for My Happy Marriage, these episodes were just great. You get more into the Kudou understanding of the family line when you see, obviously, Kudou's sister, which I'll get into in a bit. And then obviously you have in episode 6, the moment where Miyo stands up to her adoptive stepmother, or not her adoptive stepmother, her stepmother, and obviously her sister Kaya, which was absolutely freaking a great moment right then and there within itself. So getting to episode 6, it was pretty much where we last left off in terms of picking up, you know, where clearly Miyo was captured and what she needs and the situation she's in. We obviously know that Koji and Kyoka or Kudou were headed there to the Saimori household to save her. And obviously, I think the one thing we can see, the one thing I wanted to bring a mention to in this episode, was obviously the strength of Kudou. This man came into the Saimori's household literally unprovoked and did whatever he wanted to and literally just kicked ass, like absolutely made these people look like an absolute joke, right? Which was mostly just really Koji's father. Like, we know Koji's father pretty much gave him the business in episode 5 fairly easily, but then freaking Kudou comes in and absolutely mops the floor with Koji's father, which goes to show you like how strong the dude is with his abilities. Like, the guy was taking on Koji's father's attacks head on and literally had nothing. Literally, Koji's father couldn't do anything to Kudou. Like, absolutely crazy, pretty much. And the fact that this guy wanted to beat the fact that this guy wanted to beat freaking Kudou so bad to keep Miyo all to himself for his own selfish reasons, to the point he practically burned down the Saimori's household, which he's kind of responsible for, which kind of gets revealed in episode 7. He's kind of held responsible for that. It kind of goes to show you that the greed you have, you know, it kind of can backfire on you sometimes if you're doing something for an unjust cause. And again, I'll talk about the stepmother too, kind of getting what she also deserved too, as I freaking mute my other laptop, my work laptop, because a bunch of emails are popping in. But anyways, absolutely freaking crazy within itself. Now, while that's going on, Miyo's kind of pretty much getting abused by Kaya and her stepmother. And pretty much the whole thing is Kaya's trying to get Miyo to give up Kudou and say, you can have Kudou, I'll divorce him pretty much, or I'll drop the engagement so Kaya can have Kudou all to herself. Because obviously, shocker, when she realizes, oh wait, that was Kudou at the start of the episode, and she realizes, why the frick my freaking sister has a hunk of a man like that? On top of it, why does it seem like she's living insanely better than I am? Which goes to show you how selfish she is. The fact that she just can't accept, like, hey, your stepsister pretty much is living off really well on her own, and she seems like she's happy. And we know that Kaya doesn't want to see Miyo happy. She always wants to see Miyo for some odd reason all sad and depressed and everything. And I'll get to Kaya also with what's revealed with where it seems like they're taking her story in episode 7. But it was honestly just terrible to watch. As you see her get hit, slapped, you know, bullied pretty much basically by Kaya and her stepmom. The stepmother obviously takes it a little bit farther than Kaya did, but Kaya did take it pretty far. Like, I think she actually cuts the kimono that Kudou got her. And you know, and then eventually, you know, the stepmother gets involved and is like, I'm sick of this. You know, because at this point, Mio's all rejecting, which I finally appreciate, and I love that finally we get this moment where Miyo fights for herself and she fights for what she wants and what she loves. And the fact that she didn't give up Kudou so easily, because we know before she met Kudou, Miyo was kind of a submissive character. She was always giving in to what Kaya and her stepmother said about doing this and everything, and if they were treating her disrespectfully, then she would just give in to it and just be like, all right, sure, I'll just do it. But you know, in her head, as this abuse is going on, she's pretty much thinking in her head how much she doesn't want to give up everything she has got to this point, and the fact that she knows that Kudou really does appreciate her being in his household and everything. And that's when she's like, no, I'm not going to give that up. I'm not going to give up Kudou. And she keeps saying, no, she's not going to do that. And that only pisses off the stepmother and Kaya a lot more, to the point eventually, like I said, the stepmother gets involved and is like, man, fuck this shit. You will freaking do this. She like actually like starts like slapping her and freaking like hitting her and doing all these things and everything. And it's just like, what the freaking hell? And eventually, you know, they let her untie her at where she's at. And it looks like they're about to do something to her. Like, Kaya looks like she's about... I forgot, but it's been, like, a long time since I've seen the episode. But it looks like Kaya's going to do something, like, rough to her. And then that's when Kudou breaks in and is, like, seeing this. And then Kaya's like, oh, Kudou, Lord Kudou, hello and everything. You know, I wasn't doing what you think I'm doing. I was actually helping out my sister. You know, she rudely... And she's trying to sucker herself up to get Kudou to fall for her. But then the one thing I appreciate Kudou pretty much... saying, get the hell away from me. I want nothing to do with you. And he not only said that one time, he said that twice to Kaya. Basically, he's telling her, like, bitch, get the fuck out of my face. Excuse language. But that's pretty much what he's saying. Like, I don't want nothing to do with garbage like you. I don't even care. I wouldn't even freaking marry you on the spot if I wanted to. Which also goes to show, because we know Kudou, he's been in these other engagements where he's chased off these women. You have to wonder, maybe these women were kind of like women like Kaya that only cared about the riches of what Kudou could give them and everything, and they were kind of selfish being individual. Kudou never really... The reason why Kudou truly resonates and is in love with Miyo is because Miyo is somebody that he saw in a position was weak and saw it was different than the other fiancés he's had in the past, and clearly can see that, you know, Miyo is a heart... field character that actually cares about others, you know. And even like I said, the maid Yuri already knew that, because she was saying from the start, you know, like, I think this one's different than the other ones you've had. She actually like genuinely wants to go out of her way to help, and he obviously resonated with that. So Kudou, clearly he wanted somebody that was willing not only to be respectful to him but willing to freaking care about him as well too. And obviously that's what Miyo was willing to give him. And it seems like he doesn't like the other women that were kind of selfish, only wanted him just for his fame, his popularity, and his riches. He didn't appreciate that. And that's probably why he did chase those women off. But I loved how he's pretty much carried Miyo, and he was like telling Kai, like, get the hell out of my face. I want nothing to do with you. You're just a tramp and everything, you know? So that kind of makes freaking Kaya like just be absolutely shocked. In the meantime, the stepmother sees the entire damn house is on fire because the damn Koji's father was freaking so upset. He was freaking like shooting fire at Kudou just trying to stop him. And Kudou was just blocking it, but he was like spreading it around to like the surrounding, you know, area in the Samori household and everything, which it was kind of messed up. And then when you see like freaking the stepmother get like, oh, my house, what the hell happened to my house, and runs out. I'm like, see, that's what your ass gets. You know, it's completely a perfect, like, karma moment for her. You know, she was living a life and a luxurious life and everything, and all she, and she just treated her stepdaughter so wrong, and guess what? What goes around comes around, and she got her comeuppance, because it's later revealed, or it's revealed in the, like, starting point of episode 7, as we get to that, as Kudou, you know, because they go back to the household to see what's left of it, and literally what's left of the Samurai household is just a burned freaking, you know, burned ruins. It's whatever was left is just burned and tattered, and it's just like wood and everything. And we pretty much find out, like, oh, her father and her stepmother pretty much moved back to, like, some household, I think one of their relatives or whatever, and that's where they're residing at. And practically he's like, yeah, the Samurai's lost everything, so whatever riches they've had, they're, it's done. So you have to wonder if their freaking standing and hierarchy isn't as good as it once was now, because technically now you can say they're kind of a poor off family now, with the exception of Miyo. But literally because selfishness from this family and this rudeness of this family treating the daughter, they all literally, in each of their own ways, the father, the mother, and even Kai herself, they all get karma coming back at their way, and now they basically have lost everything. Like, they're basically what they were treating Miyo as, pretty much a peasant girl, a maid girl, and everything. So that's kind of the thing. They go to reveal, like, oh, Koji's father, I guess he's kind of, like, being the main culprit. He's probably gonna be put on trial, even though, like, there's no, like, legal things that are popping up as of late. So that's kind of the thing there. You get this interesting scene where Miyo touches this tree that obviously has, like, a resonation with her mother. She touches it, and it's like she gets this, like, vision. Or, like, she gets taken to this world where she sees her mother, I guess the afterlife, and pretty much her mother telling her, like, it's okay, you know, you'll be fine and everything. And obviously the tree withers away as kind of, I would say, like, a symbolic way of saying, like, I don't need to look after you anymore, Miyo. I think you're going to be in good hands under Kudou. So that's kind of the thing. And we know that tree obviously had a lot of time and memories with Miyo right then and there. Hold on a quick second before I, so it's kind of right then and there with what picks up there. Also, we kind of get the revelation about what's going on with Kaya, which I absolutely laughed. And it seems like Kaya is pretty much going to be the equivalent of what she was treating Miyo at the start of this show, which was basically a servant girl. And Kudou pretty much basically makes it out to me like, oh, she's gonna understand what it's like to, like, work for once, you know, work for something for in her life. And, you know, it's kind of crazy. She has this moment, and we cut over, she has this moment with freaking Koji, and, you know, she pretty much wants nothing to say to him, even though Koji looks like he's like, you know, is there anything else that you needed me to get you? And pretty much she's like, no. And she talks about how she lost everything, blah, 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 blah. And pretty much Kudou explains the fact that hopefully this is like a good learning lesson for her. Maybe she will get more understanding. And maybe that's where they're going to take her story. Maybe they're going to do the thing of where, okay, the terrible bitchy sister that you obviously you hate is going to get a check in reality, do what Miyo was doing, and then probably understand, holy shit, I treated my sister pretty wrong and pretty badly. And by then, her character probably changes to where she ends up being a more grateful, ends up being a character that's grateful for everything that she gets in her life, as opposed to being a spoiled rich girl, and actually understands where Miyo was coming from. And maybe we'll get a moment where she eventually apologizes to Miyo for everything she did to her, and they can truly be sisters for once. So that's kind of the whole thing. You get a moment with between Miyo and Koji where pretty much Koji apologizes for everything that happened. You know, he also asks Miyo, like, hey, do you remember what I told you, which was the whole line of, like, I'm always going to be there to protect you and everything. But Miyo kind of in a way says, like, no, I don't remember. And when I saw that scene, I'm like, you know what, it kind of actually makes me resonate. It really felt like a rejection moment right then and there. It felt like Miyo was rejecting Koji, saying, listen, dude, I understand you're my friend and you like me, but the feelings aren't there for me with you anymore. I found somebody new that I'm in love with. I think it's best we just move our separate ways and we move on, you know, just stay friends pretty much. And I think Koji really truly understood that. And I think that was a message there, kind of in a way of Miyo rejecting Koji and saying like, no, I'm not in love with you. I'm in love with somebody else. And Koji takes it respectfully and he pretty much is committed to getting stronger and, you know, willing and is ready to start his life all over again. So you have to wonder with this, that means he can probably clearly focus in on Kaya. And then obviously with Kaya's change, if we ever do see it, you know, that would only make Koji probably fall for Kaya too. And then that's when they can be obviously together and we'll see where that storyline goes. But, you know, that's kind of the thing. And then the rest of the episode is basically, the rest of the episode is basically Miyo wanting to become a, I guess you can say, a more stabilized woman or respectable wife or something like that, as she puts it. And you see this one lady show up. Now, at first, when I saw her, I'm like, oh, is this freaking Kudo's mother? I'm like, okay, Kudo's mother just dropped by. You know, we get to see the family and everything, which I think Kudo made a reference, you know, earlier in the episode about, like, you know, making the engagement official, like, you know, to meet the parents and everything. And I was like, oh, I guess we're meeting the parents right now. But no, it isn't Kudo's mother. The girl is Kudo's sister. And pretty much she's just a bundle of joy of energy. I already love her character. And she pretty much is the person to teach that is going to be teaching Miyo how to become a more civilized, or I guess, in the house woman, I guess, this more professional like woman in this period of time and everything before they, and they're going to do it, make sure she's ready and in preparation for this party that's going to be happening, right? So it's a bundle of joy energy. I like the connection between her and Miyo. You have this funny scene where, you know, Miyo pretty much is like, I really appreciate you doing this. And it's kind of like, okay, Mio's getting the sister she should have got with Kaya, a loving person that's right then and there. And you have this funny scene where Kudo's like outside the door listening to their conversation. And then obviously Miyo says something sweet and freaking Kudo's sister's like, hey, you know, Kyoka, can I take her home? And this man opens the door. He's like, hell no, you are not taking my wife home. And you can see how possessive freaking Kudo is. It's honestly freaking cute as hell. It's funny and cute as hell because it just shows you how much this man Kudo loves Miyo. He's like, nah, you're not having him. You're not having my fiance all to yourself. So that was all funny and everything. And that's pretty much kind of it. Kind of too serious cliffhanger lift, you know, in episode 6, you get left off on this cliffhanger with this one guy that apparently wants Miyo too. And then we get left off with this cliffhanger where we see these people, I guess this seal is broken to this graveyard or whatever. And it's told to Kudo that this seal has been broken. And I don't know if that's good. We only see like these red eyes in the dusk of clouds after this seal is broken, apparently. I don't know what that's supposed to mean, like these creatures that apparently Miyo can see with her abilities, which she has another, I guess, one of those bad dream things. They don't really go into in depth what she's having dreaming about in this dream. It's just obviously you can tell she must be going through those dreams and it has to do something with these creatures or these abilities or these spirits, I guess you can say. And then also it's revealed too at the end of the episode, there's this guy with glasses that apparently also wants Miyo. I'm like, geez Louise, all these freaking dudes want Miyo. So clearly Kudo's gonna have to go out of his way to freaking protect her like crazy. But we'll see. But this show is really freaking underrated, really freaking good. I am loving this show. It's definitely like probably up there with the many other of these shows I've been watching this summer of anime. It's definitely like a top hitter for summer of anime in terms of new content we've been getting. So yeah, but anyways, I think I talked long enough about this freaking show and my thoughts on it. So if you guys like the video, leave a like. Put in the comment section your thoughts on this week's episode for the last 2 weeks episodes of Jeez Louise, come on man, My Happy Marriage, as well as hit that subscribe button if you want to get more My Happy Marriage content or any other anime content I upload to the channel. And yeah, but till then guys, stay safe up there, have a great rest of your day or night or whenever you're checking out this video. Until then guys, stay safe up there, peace.